अस्सलामु अलैकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातहू। वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द सेशन ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, दैट इज इंटीरियर ऑफ द अर्थ। आई एम इंजीनियर जावेद होरा, स्मार्ट क्लास ट्रेनर फॉर अल हबीब GPMS गुंजांगीर एंड वेलकम कोचिंग क्लासेस। In this session, today we will learn about the interior of the earth, its crust, mantle, core, rocks and their types, uses of rocks, rock cycle and mineral. Let us start our session for today with the planet earth. The earth in which humans live is not absolute spherical in shape. Going towards the interior of the earth, the picture shown on the screen shows the layers of the earth, that is crust, mantle, outer core and inner core. The earth is like onion, which is made up of several layers. Starting crust, the uppermost layer over the earth's surface is called the crust. It is the thinnest of all the layers. It is 35 km thick on the landmass, continental masses, and only 5 km on the ocean floors. Main mineral constituents of the continental mass are silica and alumina. Thus it is called Sial, Si silica and Al alumina. The oceanic crust mainly consists of silica and magnesium. Thus it is called Sima, Si silica and Ma magnesium. Going towards the mantle, this layer extends up to the depth of 2900 km before the crust. And the core, the innermost layer is the core. The radius of core is about 3500 km. It is mainly made up of nickel and iron. Thus, it is called a knife. Ni nickel and Fe ferrous, that is iron. The central core has very high temperature and pressure. Going towards the rocks, any natural mass of mineral matter that makes up the earth's crust is called a rock. It can be of different color, size and texture. There are mainly three major types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks and metamorphic rocks. Let us discuss the first, igneous rock. When the molten magma cools, it becomes solid and are called igneous rocks. They are also called primary rocks. There are two types of igneous rock: intrusive rocks, extrusive rocks. Defining extrusive rock, when the molten lava comes on the earth's surface, it rapidly cools down and becomes solid on the crust. These rocks are called extrusive igneous rocks. They have a very fine granular structure. Example, basalt. The Deccan Plateau is made up of basalt rocks. Intrusive rock, when the molten magma cools down deep inside the earth's crust, giving formation of solid rocks, are called intrusive igneous rocks. Since they cool down slowly, they form large grains. Example, granite. Grinding stones used to prepare paste, powder of spices and grains are made up of granite. Going towards the sedimentary rocks, Rocks roll down, crack, and hit each other and are broken down into smaller fragments, which are called sediments. These sediments are transported and deposited by wind, water, etc. These loose sediments are compressed and hardened to form layer of rocks. These types of rocks are called sedimentary rocks. Example, sandstone is made from grains of sand. Sedimentary rocks may also contain fossils of plants, animals, and other microorganisms that once lived on them. Going towards the third type, that is a metamorphic rock. Under great heat and pressure, igneous and sedimentary rocks can change into metamorphic rocks. Example, clay changes into slate and limestone into marble. Uses of rocks. Rocks are used for construction activities such as making buildings, roads. They are source of minerals which are useful for various purposes in daily life. Rock cycle. The process of transformation of the rock from one to another is known as the rock cycle. It describes the changes among the three main types of rocks that are igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic rocks. Picture shown on the screen shows the rock cycle. When the molten magma cools, it solidifies to become igneous rock. These igneous rocks are broken down into smaller particles by various agents such as weathering, temperature, wind, etc., and are transported and deposited to form sedimentary rocks. These smaller grains of rocks keep moving towards basins and lower regions and gradually form sedimentary rocks. When the igneous and sedimentary rocks are subjected to heat and pressure, they change into metamorphic rocks. The metamorphic rocks, which are still under great heat and pressure, melt down to form molten magma. This molten magma again can cool down and solidify into igneous rocks. And this process takes hundreds and thousands of years. Minerals. Minerals are naturally occurring substances which have certain physical properties and definite chemical composition. These are very important for humans. For example, coal, natural gas, and petroleum. They are also used in industries. Iron, aluminium, gold, uranium, etc. And in medicine, in fertilizers, etc. Hope you would have learned keenly this session of geography by Engineer Javed Hora. Thanks for watching our session of geography for class 5th, 6th, and 7th. Engineer Javed Hora, Smart Class Trainer for Welcome Coaching Classes Gundi Jahangir and Al Habib GPMS Gundi Jahangir. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.